Brothers and sisters in Islam, Imams al-Bukhari and Muslim reported on the authority of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مثل جليس الصالح والسوء كحامل المسك ونافخ الكيل فحامل المسك إما أن يحذيك وإما أن تبتاع منه وإما أن تجد منه ريحا طيبة ونافخ الكيل إما أن يحرق ثيابك وإما أن تجد ريحا خبيثة. The similitude of a good company and a bad company is like that of the owner of musk and the blacksmith. The owner of musk would either gift you, or you would buy from him, or at least you would smell a pleasant fragrance. Whereas the blacksmith would either burn your clothes, or at least you would smell a detestful smell from him. Allah Azza wa Jal decreed that mankind has an inclination and a need to be in the company of others, to mix with others. Allah Azza wa Jal decreed that people need one another. Allah decreed that people become friends. And He subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, decreed that this inclination is something that's in human's nature. And this friendship or company is something that has a strong influence and a direct impact on the person's way of thinking, his behavior, his manners, his methodology, and even his faith and religion. A person in the company of good people will have someone always to benefit him in one way or another. And on the contrary, if he is in the company of bad or evil people, he would have someone harming him in one way or another. That's because people differ in their personalities and characters and manners. Some are good, they are beneficial, and some are bad, who are harmful. And this is why the emphasis were put on whom you keep company with or befriend. They can either be your way to bliss and happiness in this life and the hereafter, or your misery. There's an Arabic saying that translates to, tell me who's your company, I will tell you who you are. Your identity is recognized by the company you surround yourself with. It is very dangerous It is a very serious matter. The matter of your friends and your company. For example, it is not acceptable for a believer, a practicing Muslim, to choose an evil person as a friend, or an evil or a bad group as company. Those who sin, those who use foul language, those who are obscene, it's not befitting for a believer to surround himself, to accept for himself to be in such an environment. Because that will directly influence his practice, his faith. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us, Abu Hurairah narrates, and this is reported by Al-Imam Abu Dawood and classified as sound by Al-Albani. He said, "Al-mar'u 'ala dini khalilihi falyanzur ahadukum man yukhalil wa fi lafdhin man yukhalit." Man will be or will follow the religion of the person with whom he keeps company, in another narration, with whom he mixes. The person you hang around with, or the group of people you hang around with, will influence your faith. See, people are one or two. You're either a strong personality person and can be a source of influence, or the other way around, and others will influence you. There is no neutral person. You either influence others, or others will influence you. That's why one should not take the risk with his faith and religion by keeping the wrong company around him. And because of the importance of this matter and the seriousness of its outcomes, Islam gave us direct and clear instructions as to whom we take as company and friends. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated, and this is reported by Imam Abu Dawood and classified as sound by Al-Albani, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "La tusahib illa mu'mina." Don't be in the company of anyone except a believer. So this environment you place yourself in, and by environment I mean those you hang around with, your friends, work colleagues, those you travel with, those you go and play soccer, football, baseball, go swimming with, go on picnics with, whatever you dine with. This environment can be lethal, can be deadly on our faith and our religion. Why? Because at a moment of heedlessness and weakness of our heart, one of this bad company can say a word that will go directly to the heart and firmly settle, which can lead us to deviate and follow desires. Or, and this is something that's becoming widespread, atheism. Got a lot of youth coming and talking to me about the existence of Allah, and should we accept that Allah exists or not, and the soundness of faith and the soundness of Islam and the existence of such a faith. I know a person who memorized 1/4 of the Mus'haf, 1/4 of the Quran, with the reasons of revelation and the explanation of this 1/4 of the Mus'haf, but because he worked under a boss who was an atheist and who was smart in the field they were working in, they were electrical engineers, this man left Islam altogether in a matter of a year or two because of this evil company. So it is dangerous to be in the company of the wrong people. That's why once we find the right company, we need to hold on to them strongly. Because it's very easy to lose a friend, but it's very difficult to make the right friend. It's very difficult to find the right friend, especially in an era like ours, where those who are practicing Muslims don't easily come around. So we need to, once we find them, we need to be patient. We need to be patient because things happen. People are of different personalities and we will have differences. So don't give up your friendship with someone who's good, someone who's pious because of a mistake or two, because there is no one who is infallible in this world. They were not created. Allah Azza wa Jal addressed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاةِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ وَلَا تَعْدُ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ تُرِيدُ زِينَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ and bring yourself patiently to be around those who call upon their Lord in the morning and in the evening, seeking his face, meaning his pleasure. And don't let your eyes pass beyond them, seeking the pleasure and adornment of this worldly life. So once we find those who remind us with Allah, who keep us on track, we need to be patient. We need to persevere, because all types of relationships are subject to dispute, misunderstandings, and so on and so forth. The effect of the environment one places himself in psychologically is great. You often hear people complain. They're not content with anything. They come and talk to me about how bad this life is and how bad the world is and how gloomy their lives are. And when you dig deep inside, you see that they have the worst kind of company. They're not content. Why? Because the environment they place themselves in does not help. They're psychologically depressed because of that. On the other hand, you see the person whom Allah blessed to have the right company, to be a friend of pious and practicing people, always cheerful and happy. Why? Because this is the real happiness and joy, being a practicing believer who's surrounded with people who help you do so, is the real joy in this life. It is the source of happiness. You don't have anyone betraying you. You don't hear anything evil. You don't see anything evil. All you see around you is good. And when a mistake is committed, or an evil is done, it's by mistake. It's not intentional. Again, because we're humans. And thus, the emphasis on the good company and good friends. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to bless us with the right environment, with good company, with good friends who take us by hand
to the path that pleases him subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشانه. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه وعلى آله وأصحابه وإخوانه. ثم أما بعد. Never befriend or be in the company of a person whose actions or words don't bring you closer to Allah. As a rule. Now, this doesn't mean that one cannot deal with the other type of people. But there's a difference between dealing with them. The Prophet ﷺ dealt with the Jews. But we're differentiating between those whom you befriend and stay in the company of, and those whom with whom you have dealings. That's a different story. We're talking about those who are going to be your environment, your surrounding, your friends, your company. Never be in the company or befriend someone whose actions or words don't bring you closer to Allah the Almighty. I heard a lot from people that whenever they're in a surrounding of, say, a Muslim convention or an i'tikaf or an Islamic gathering, they feel enthused, they're encouraged to do good. Right? Their zeal goes up. They're more keen. Why? Because they're surrounded with those whose actions are such that encourage you. They see someone reciting the Quran, another one uttering Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, this one giving a lecture, this one giving a talk, this one encouraging. See, when you're surrounded with those who are good, you'll see an extended hand all the time, which encourages you to repent, pushes you forward to piety and righteousness and virtue. On the other hand, if the company is evil, if you don't go down to the level of committing the evil they're committing, the least that will happen is that you will share them, or with them rather, the sin they incur. For example, you're sitting in a gathering where people are backbiting and gossiping, right? And you don't indulge yourself in backbiting. Well, you're not totally rescued and saved from punishment. Why? Because by sitting there accepting what's going on around you, makes you a partner. Makes you incur the same sin as they did. So they'll be like the blacksmith to you. They'll either burn your clothes or you find this disgustful smell from them. That's why such people will regret it on the day of judgment. As Allah tells us, وَيَوْمَ يَعَبُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَىٰ يَدَيْهِ يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا يا ويلتا ليتني لم أتخذ فلانا خليلا لقد أضلني عن الذكر بعد إذ جاءني. And when the wrongdoer would bite his hands in regret, on that day, ويوم يعض الظالم على يديه. And what would he say? يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. I wish I had taken with the messenger away, followed the way of the messenger. يَا وَيْلَتَا. Oh, woe to me. I wish I
hadn't taken such as so and so as a friend. Why? لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي. He had misguided me. عَنِ الذِّكْرِ, from the remembrance of Allah after it has reached me. Regret, but to no avail. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal warned us and prohibited upon us to be in the company of those who commit mistakes, who commit sins. Not mistakes, sins. Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ يَخُوضُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا فَأَعْرِضْ عَنْهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ. And if you see those who indulge offensively regarding our faith, our verses, then stay away from them until they indulge in another conversation. وَإِمَّا يُنْسِيَنَّكَ الشَّيْطَانِ. And if shaytan should cause you to forget, فَلَا تَقْعُدْ بَعْدَ الذِّكْرَى مَعَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Then do not sit after you remember, after you pay attention to what's going on, you're in the wrong environment, don't sit once you remember with the wrongdoing people. Now, having said all of this, brothers and sisters, we are not, Islam does not call you to seclude yourself, to sit alone. No, as a matter of fact, there are clear instructions to be with the Muslim community, to be in a group. Why? Because it's dangerous as well to be alone. Abu Darda, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a part of a long hadith, he said, the wolf will only eat the sheep that wanders alone away from the flock. This is reported by Ahmad and classified as sound by Al-Albani. As a matter of fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam directly gave instructions to be with the group of Muslims, the Muslim community. When he said in the report by Ahmad, classified as authentic by Al-Bani, and narrated by Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, stick to the Muslim group. عليكم بالجماعة. So the idea here is not to be alone, but what it is to be selective, to choose, to pick those whom you will be in the company of. Because it is always better to be in a group. For example, a person who prays alone at home is a believer, is practicing, but he is subjecting himself to temptations and trials. Why? Because he's alone, he doesn't have a defensive line. Whereas, when he is with the congregation, he's got the source of protection and prevention. He's got a group of Muslims. He will have people to encourage him to do good. And when they see him drifting or committing a sin, they will advise him. They will try to prevent him kindly. However, and I will conclude with this, if one fails to find in a certain community he lives in, if one fails to find the right environment, what should he do? He should stay alone. He should seclude himself if he can't find an environment that will help him come close to Allah. In the story, of the people of the cave. Today is Friday, we recite Surah Al-Kahf every Friday, or at least we should. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned the story of the youth, the young men who believed, and all their people were disbelievers. When they feared for their faith and could not secure an environment that will help them maintain their faith and relationship with Allah, they went into the cave. And I'm not calling people to go to caves, but I'm saying when the environment is not the environment that Allah Azza wa Jal is pleased with, and this can happen. This can exist, especially in the West. There are many towns that have a small community of Muslims who are professionals. They hardly see one another, right? They don't even have a masjid. Sometimes they might gather in somebody's house to pray Jum'ah, right? In such an environment, what can someone do? Well, work on yourself alone. Because when these people in Surah Al-Kahf could not find the suitable environment, they retreated to the cave. Our cave can be our house, can be our family. And as the saying goes, if you can't find good company, then it is best to stay alone. So we need to work hard, brothers and sisters, on placing ourselves in the right environment and being watchful of the environment as parents that our kids are placing themselves in. Because peer pressure can be destructive. Peer pressure can be destructive, so we need to be watchful. We need to monitor. And it's our responsibility in front of Allah Azza wa Jal, because Allah Azza wa Jal put them under our guardianship. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to protect us and our families from evil company. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا